Cinematography is a beautiful art form. Today I get to take you guys on the journey of one of my favorite cinematographers, Hoyte Van Hoytema. Hoyte Van Hoytema is a Dutch-Swedish cinematographer who is 49 years old. He wasn't always interested in cinematography, however. Hoyte aspired to be a filmmaker slash director, so he applied for the Netherlands Film Academy, where he'd be ejected from twice. On a family trip to Poland, his friend asked him about film school and his aspirations and recommended he go to the National Film School in Lodz, Poland. He would spend 3 years there, learning about different contemporary filmmaking techniques and knowledge, such as working with light, shooting film, working with film emulsions, and shooting various student projects. At the school, he'd meet connections and friendships that would even last, which he quotes till this day, saying he can go anywhere in Europe and connect with a buddy from film school and create projects with them all over Europe. Fresh out of film school, Hoyte by no means was working on big productions. His brother and Hoyte would work together in the construction and architecture industry, where he'd later create his own production company. His first jobs that would bridge the gap for him, which eventually led him to making narrative films or making music videos for local artists. During his time with his brother and his production company, he also worked as a gaffer, photographer, and camera operator on various different sets and small corporate projects for different individuals. In this time, Hoyte aspired to be something more, so he wanted to make the shift to narrative projects in the late 1990s. In 2002, he'd receive his first job in television as a cinematographer on a show called The First Gypsy in Space. This project wouldn't bring him nearly as much acclaim as his future projects, but was a big opportunity at the time. As he was quoted saying this before, he was smoking cigarettes all day in his apartment and in his underwear, so at the time, the opportunity to shoot a television show was great. After this, he'd shoot TV, documentaries, and smaller feature films. It wasn't until 2008, with the help of his friend, he'd work with Thomas Alfredson on a project called Let the Right One In, which eventually became a cult classic and an international hit. For this film, he received a Goldbridge Award for Best Cinematography, which is the equivalent of the Swedish Oscar. Also, the Nordic Vision Award for Best Cinematography. This would lead to him being reached out to from an American agent, where he'd get to shoot his first commercial American film, called The Fighter by David O. Russell. So if we're talking about timelines, it took him from 1997 to 2010, which is roughly 13 years of not giving up, practical experience, and hard work. So, who is he now? In 2013, Wally Pfister, the previous cinematographer for Christopher Nolan, would step away from his role, and Hoyte Van Hoytema would get the opportunity to be the cinematographer for one of my favorite movies, Interstellar. Hoyte is now established as a top-tier cinematographer. A top-tier cinematographer can earn anywhere from $10,000 to $20,000 a week, with typical shooting schedules being 8 weeks or more depending on the project. Hoyte would later get various different movies to work on, and most recently, the big blockbuster The Tenant, and one of my favorite movies, Dunkirk. Ultimately, this project inspires me to keep going, learning my craft, being okay with where I'm at, shooting awesome projects in the meantime, making great connections, and ultimately understanding it may take 10 years for someone to call me an overnight success.